Omnition Analysis Software is a companion bioinformatics pipeline for Bio-Rad single-cell assays. This video provides an overview of how to run the ATAC data analysis module with Omnition version 1.0.0. As part of our single-cell ATAC-seq solution, Omnition takes fast-Q sequencing files generated with the ddSEQ ATAC library prep kit, performs quality control, pre-processing, data analysis, and reporting, and outputs count matrices that are ready for downstream analyses. Users can download Omnition Analysis Software as a standalone copy by going to the Bio-Rad website and clicking the download button, which will direct you to the Omnition repository on GitHub. Additionally, if users have the Omnition dependency components such as Nextflow and Docker or Singularity, users can run Omnition from the Linux, Unix command line without downloading a standalone copy. Omnition provides reference, analysis, and full workflows. The full workflow combines the reference and analysis workflows. If users use the same reference genomes for multiple experiments, it is recommended to run the reference workflow once, then run the analysis workflow on each experiment file. This can minimize runtime overall. Alternatively, users can run the full workflow on each experiment if desired. Let's take a look at the reference workflow. For this workflow, users must provide Ensemble FASTA files and GTF files for their species of choice. An optional block list may be included. The block list contains the list of genomic regions to be excluded from the final output files. The final file required is a YAML file containing all the parameters set by the user. Omnition will then prepare the required reference files needed for the analysis workflow, including BWA index and TSS window bed files. If no blocklist was provided, Omnition will produce an empty blocklist bed file that can be used in the analysis workflow, though all genome regions will still be included in all output files. The YAML file specifies which workflow the user is running. It also contains the path to each of the required input files. To save the YAML file, simply name the file and include .yaml at the end. Here we name the file reference.yaml. Once the YAML file is saved, users can store the reference output files by typing this command in the command line after navigating to the directory where they would like to have the files stored. Once you hit enter, the Bio-Rad logo will appear and Omnition will begin running. The time it takes Omnition to run will depend on how large your input files are and your computing power. Once the reference workflow is completed, you'll find all these reference files in the folder that you started Omnition in. These will be used for the analysis workflow in the next step. Now you are ready to run an analysis workflow on your samples. The Omnition analysis workflow will take your fast-Q files, as well as the prepared reference files, and perform alignment, deconvolution, QC, and other secondary analyses. The output files can then be used in downstream tertiary analyses for biological interpretation. The user will need to provide a new YAML file that is different from the one supplied for the reference workflow. This YAML file will contain additional parameters and specify the analysis workflow option. Additionally, a block list has been added to the YAML. Finally, this YAML file must include input parameter, listing the directory path to fast-Q files for all the samples you wish to analyze. We will save this YAML file as analysis.yaml. To begin the Omnition analysis workflow, the script is very similar as the reference workflow. The key difference is that we specify the analysis YAML file instead of the reference one. Once Omnition begins, you will see this output. Once complete, you will have a results folder containing the following different outputs. In the sample files folder, you'll find all the output files, including count matrix and peak information necessary for downstream analyses. If you analyzed more than one sample, an individual sample subfolder will be included as well. In the pipeline info folder, you'll find information about the Omnition pipeline, including a record of the previous screen, as well as a more detailed record of the different steps Omnition performed on your samples. The final folder, named Report, contains a record of the parameters you set in your YAML file. It also contains an HTML file that reports QC, analysis, and ATAC metrics for all your samples processed in a single Omnition run. The attack report is a useful tool in evaluating whether your experiment works as expected, as well as determining if you have high-quality data for any downstream analyses. At the top of the report are six tabs: experimental summary, read QC, analysis statistics, deconvolution, attack metrics, and results. On the left-hand side is a drop-down menu you can use to switch between different samples if multiple samples were processed together through the analysis workflow. If you are not sure about what a metric means in each table or graph, hover your cursor over the question mark on the right-hand side for more information. The first tab, Experiment Summary, summarizes key metrics and statistics for each sample. It also contains any status messages produced by Omnition. The Read QC tab shows the mean FRED quality score at each base position as a measure of base quality in sequencing. Below that is the sequence trace heat map, showing the proportion of each of the four DNA bases being called at each position. You can click on one of the read positions for either read 1 or read 2 to switch to the sequence trace plot view. This provides another way to view the mean nucleotide composition at each base position. The Analysis Statistics tab provides summaries of alignment metrics and read pair information. Below those tables is the alignment distribution plot, illustrating the number of reads that aligned to the different chromosome locations listed in your reference genome. The sequence saturation plot shows the number of unique fragments identified compared to the number of valid reads per cell. The deconvolution tab contains information on how well Omnition was able to parse out all the sequenced barcodes and identify those that contain information from nuclei. This tab includes metrics on the outcome of bead filtration in both a table and a graph, as well as information about how many beads per partition were captured and how well beads with shared fragments were merged to bring the genomic information of an individual cell together. In Attack Metrics tab, you will find information relating specifically to ATAC-seq results. These attack metrics are reported both in a table and in plots illustrating key metrics, including the transcription start site enrichment, insert size distribution, unique nuclear and mitochondrial fragments per cell, TSS proportion, duplicate proportion, and estimated library size. All these metrics are useful when determining if you have high-quality data and whether the experiment was successful. The Results tab provides a table that highlights key results for the experiment. It also includes a UMAP cluster plot for all the barcode-containing nuclei. If your samples contained two species, such as human and mouse, you would also have a table and a graph showing the crosstalk statistics, including the number of unique fragments identified for each species and those associated with both, otherwise known as the crosstalk. With all the information included in this report, the user can access the quality of their data and performance of Omnition. Finally, we'll review the full workflow, which contains all the steps performed in the reference and analysis workflows. To run the full workflow, the analysis YAML file must be changed. Set the workflow parameter to full. You don't need to include a block list file. Once you have completed your full workflow YAML file, you can save it as full.yaml. Then you will start Omnition in the same way as in the analysis workflow. The results files will be the same as if you had run the reference and analysis workflows separately. Now that you have completed either the full workflow or the analysis workflow, you will have the required files necessary to run your downstream analysis of interest. This could include clustering, differential peak analysis, or transcription factor motif analysis, to name a few examples. For detailed tutorials, please stay tuned for our upcoming videos on tertiary analyses using Omnition output as input files. Thank you for watching our overview and tutorial on running the Omnition pipeline. Please email support at bio-rad.com if you have any questions or suggestions.